Hi everyone, it's Salim and welcome back to a new episode of Street Foods at Home. And this time we are going to the Punjabi kitchen in India. When I think of India, I am imagining street foods vibrating with a lot of people and a huge amount of food stalls with different smells everywhere, delicious smells of food. Today we're going to be trying creating this environment in my own kitchen. Let's go and try. The word samosa can be traced to the Persian word sambusaj, while they are currently referred to as sambusak in the Arabic-speaking world. Medieval Arabic recipe books sometimes spell it sambusaj. The samosa originated in the Middle East and Central Asia, in the spread to Africa, Southeast Asia, South Asia and elsewhere. The term samosa and its variants cover a family of pastries and dumplings from Northeastern Africa to Western China. The samosa spread to the Indian subcontinent following the invasion of the Central Asian Turkic dynasties in the region. Central Asian samosa were introduced to the Indian subcontinent in the 13th or 14th century by traders from Central Asia. A samosa is a fried or baked pastry with a savory filling that can be made of potatoes, onions, peas, cheese, beef and other meats or lentils. It may take different forms including triangular, cone or half moon shapes depending on the region. The Indian style, often accompanied by a chutney, is probably the most widely known of a broad family of recipes from Africa to China, which have origins in medieval times or earlier. Samosa is a popular appetizer or snack in the Indian cuisine. The samosa is typically made of all-purpose flour and stuffed with some filling, like a mixture of mashed boiled potatoes, onions, green peas, lentils, paneer, spices, and green chili or fruits. It can be vegetarian or non-vegetarian, depending on the filling. The samosa is often served hot and is often eaten with fresh green chutney. Usually, samosas are deep fried to a golden brown color in vegetable oil. Here we go. Some delicious homemade Indian samosas at my own kitchen. Crispy on the outside and very soft on the inside because of the potatoes, and there is a delicious flavorful taste of all the spices and herbs that I put in there. Early in this episode, I was describing the street of India that were packed with people and a lot of food stalls, and I feel that I am in the streets of India only by eating this. This is so delicious. Making Indian samosas, well, I'm not gonna say that it was a super easy process because of the multi steps that this recipe has, but it is worth it. And I'm sure that your kids will love these delicious snacks. I'm not really into veggie things, but this tastes delicious. This is one of those treats that you should make at home on special occasions or on weekends when you want to have some fun at home. These samosas is crispy and flaky, and they taste exactly as the ones from your favorite shop. They are filled with flavorful potatoes and a lot of herbs, but the joy of biting into this crispy, flaky little thing filled with spicy potatoes, it all worth it. I know Indian people, they go crazy for samosas together with a cup of chai tea. Therefore, I'm gonna be enjoying a cup of tea myself. That was it for this episode and my lovely Indian samosas that was made at my own kitchen. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next week in another episode of Street Food at Home. And don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Have a good one. See you.